Good morning students, welcome to the online teaching session of Academic World School Vimitra. Today we are here again with chemistry lessons of class 9, first chapter, that is matter in our surrounding. Last class we studied about different states of matter. Today first we will be discussing about diffusion along with the Brownian movement and then the change of states of matter. First of all, we will discuss the Brownian movement. Robert Brown who is a Scottish scientist in 1827 discovered the movement of falling rains in water. As we studied in the earlier classes, matter is continuously moving. The particles in matter are in continuous motion. So, according to that, Robert Brown started a science or discovery how things are going on. He observed that pollen grains in water, as they always float in water. Now, he studied the movement of pollen grain in water. Whenever he was observing, he observed that pollen grains are continuously in motion in the water. Now, while moving in the water, they are colliding with each other. Two substances moving together, it is supposed that they will be sometimes collide with each other. After the collision, their direction will change. The pollen grain like that, they collide with each other and their direction changes. That means whenever particle matters are there, they are in continuous motion, they are supposed to collide with each other along with the medium in which they are present. For example, dust and smoke. Example, dust and smoke. Whenever they are floating in the air or they are moving in the air, they collide with themselves as well as with the air particle. Now, whenever they collide, their direction is supposed to change. Now, Robert Brown, he told a motion or he described a motion that is called Brownian movement, and all the particles, when they exist in nature, they follow a trend, that is the zigzag motion, random motion. So he says, suppose this is a particle, its motion, you can see in the figure, this motion is called Brownian movement or the random motion according to the Scottish scientist Robert Brown. Why we are discussing this concept? Because we will be studying today diffusion. For diffusion, we need to know the Brownian movement. Because of this Brownian movement, there are intermixing of states of matter or the particles of matter. Gas, gas diffusion, gas into liquid diffusion, liquid into gas diffusion. So this kind of diffusion we will study. Because of that, Brownian motion is required or the random motion is required. So next we will be moving to our next topic, that is diffusion. Diffusion, it is a vast concept. Initially, let me tell you, it is defined as intermixing of particles with each other without any external force. For example, as we studied in earlier classes, suppose a beaker of water is there and we draw a drop of ink in it. Drop of blue ink in it. After being dropped, what will happen? It will spread through the water without any external agent. So the ink will start moving in the water so that it distributes itself uniformly throughout the water. So this movement, according to Robert Brown, of the particles is called the Brownian movement, and diffusion is just the result of Brownian movement. You can see the mixing of color in water, the mixing of smell in air, the mixing of milk in water, water in milk. Any mixing you see, the particles which get submerged in another particle or any substance gets submerged in another substance, mixing of salt, sugar in water, they are the example of diffusion. So what are the characteristics of diffusion and how it happens? Today we will be discussing with point wise description. Number one, due to Brownian movement, diffusion takes place. Due to Brownian movement, that means due to the movement of particles, as we studied in the earlier classes, the particles of matter are in continuous motion. So this motion, this random motion of particles are called Brownian motion. So diffusion is just the result of Brownian motion. Second, if we increase the temperature, when we increase the temperature, the particles get high kinetic energy. You heat anything, it will gain more energy and the movement of the particles of that substance will become faster. Take the example of solid liquid gas. If you heat solid, the particles will gain energy, they will become liquid. Again, you heat liquid, the particles of the matter of the liquid will gain energy, they will become gas, then plasma. So these things, they go on. Now, on increasing temperature, diffusion occurs faster. If we increase temperature, the diffusion will occur at a faster rate. The vice versa is also true. That means if we decrease temperature, if temperature is decreased, the energy is taken out from the particles or the substance, so the particles start moving slowly. As that energy becomes less, more is the energy, higher is the movement, and vice versa. Number three, from high concentration to low concentration. So what is high concentration? Take the example of diffusion of ink into water. So whenever ink is there in the pen or in the dropper where we are supposed to drop it in the water, high concentration of ink is there. And in water, the concentration of ink becomes lesser because it spreads out. Now, what is the direction of flow of the ink? From ink to water, that means high concentration of ink to low concentration of ink. So this is the third point of diffusion, that means diffusion occurs from high concentration to low concentration. Another example you can take, you all of us we use perfume. Now perfume is meant for giving good smell, pleasant smell. Now this pleasant smell goes from our body to the surrounding. That means in our body when we apply it, the concentration of the perfume is higher. More is the concentration. Now, when we move outside our home, the smell or the perfume, it starts moving outside the body. Now, when it starts moving outside, that means it moves from higher concentration to lower concentration. Still, it persists and people around us, they get the smell of the perfume that we have applied in our body. Next point, fourth. Diffusion is a natural process. Natural process means everywhere during rainy season you can smell the smell of the earth, you can smell the smell of the wet tree, the leaves, the different kind of processes happens during the natural happenings. Now this is completely a natural process, as we don't apply any outside force or any artificial force, any man-made force or any masculine force. Without applying any other force, extra force, the diffusion can take place. So it is a completely natural process. Next point, diffusion takes place in solid, liquid and gas. Since it is the intermixing of particles, the diffusion process, it takes place in all the three states of matter. Since we are not discussing about other two states, that is plasma and BEC, because they don't exist in our room temperature or in our day-to-day life. We don't see much of the plasma particles in our day-to-day life. So we'll be sticking to solid, liquid and gas. So in the three states of matter, the diffusion can take place. We'll be elaborating a little more how diffusion takes place in solid, liquid and gas. All of you can pause the screen and you can take the note. As we know, the inter-particle attraction in solid is maximum. So, solid diffusion is not likely happening in many cases. But there are examples where solid gets diffused in liquid, liquid gets diffused in solid, gases get diffused in liquid. One of the best examples I will be giving, the diffusion of solid, liquid, gas into liquid. You see, you take beaker of water. If we add sugar to it, it will get diffused. If we add salt, again it will get diffused. It will take time, sugar, salt, they will take time, but automatically after some time, naturally, without any external force, they will get diffused. This is the example of solid, liquid diffusion. Again, liquid-liquid diffusion. Suppose I draw red color. Suppose I draw a drop of red color in water. What will happen? After coming to the surface of the water, this color will start moving in the water. So the entire water will become red. So this is an example of liquid diffusion. Next is the gas in liquid diffusion. It is a very easy and common example. You see, the water surfaces present on Earth, they are in continuous contact with the atmosphere. That means they are in contact with the air. As you know, air contains 21% of oxygen. So, the atmospheric oxygen continuously gets diffused in the water bodies present in the earth surface. Now, since this is the water surface, because of the continuous contact with the air, the atmospheric oxygen gets dissolved or diffused in water, which is called dissolved oxygen. And because of this dissolved oxygen, the aquatic animals like fishes, marine species, aquatic plants, so this contains 78% of nitrogen and other 1% it contains argon, carbon dioxide, etc. So in the water bodies, all the gases including oxygen, carbon dioxide, nitrogen, these all are present in some particular proportion. But to get the best example, the fishes, they do not dissociate water into oxygen and hydrogen and they consume. It is not correct. They use the dissolved oxygen. As you know, wherever there are more plants which are grown in any pond or any other water bodies, the fishes cannot grow there because those plants, they use the oxygen that is dissolved in water completely. So there is no oxygen left for the fishes. So either they die or they move to another place. Now, these are the example of solid-liquid diffusion, liquid-liquid diffusion, and gas to liquid diffusion. So one of the most important questions here, how fishes breathe in water. The answer is they intake the dissolved oxygen in water. And same case, the aquatic plants that is present in the oceans or in the rivers or in the ponds, any water body, plants, they use carbon dioxide and oxygen both. Okay, so these are the examples of some diffusion. So here we studied gas, liquid, diffusion. Again coming to gas and gas diffusion. Gas and gas diffusion. So very simple, if you take perfume bottle, if you take a perfume bottle and spray the perfume in the air, what happens? The entire room starts giving the smell of that particular perfume or that particular smell, pleasant smell. So this is the example of diffusion of gas into gas. So here we saw different examples of solid-liquid diffusion, liquid-liquid diffusion, gas-liquid diffusion, gas-gas diffusion. So here we can draw a conclusion which state of matter undergoes high diffusion. Rate of diffusion you will see in gaseous, it is higher because more space are there. Anything that wants to get diffused, it will get more space in gaseous state, so it will diffuse easily. Then liquid and then solid. In solid it is practically not very possible because interparticle space or intermolecular space is very less. Since space is very less, the particles that wants to get diffused, or if we want to diffuse, they do not get enough place to get diffused. So solid diffusion is not practically possible. Some exceptions are there, but in solid diffusion is not likely to be present every day. In liquid and gas, this is the order: gas, high rate of diffusion; liquid, moderate rate of diffusion; and solid, least rate of diffusion. So this was the concept of diffusion. Last two classes also we discussed some cases of diffusion. For example, the sizzling food, the smell of sizzling food comes to us very easily, whereas we don't get the smell of the ice cream. Again, the incense stick. If we put one incense stick, burning incense stick, in one corner of the room, you will get the smell in other room or in another corner of the room very fast. So that is the case of gas diffusion. And more is the kinetic energy in the particle, more is the diffusion. So there are some formulas. Second formula, temperature. Is directly proportional to diffusion. Any state of matter, you increase the temperature, the diffusion of that matter or that substance in another substance will be easier, because particles of the matter will get more kinetic energy. Number three, kinetic energy is directly proportional to diffusion. More is the kinetic energy of the substance or of the particle matter, more will be the diffusion. The diffusion is directly proportional to the kinetic energy, and there is a direct relation between kinetic energy and temperature. More is the temperature, more is the kinetic energy. Less is the temperature, less is the kinetic energy. That means temperature directly proportional to kinetic energy. So physical relation also we can find out for different characteristics of diffusion. So this was the concept of diffusion. Next we will be moving to our next topic, that is interconversion of state of matter. Change of state of matter. So state of matter is a stable form of matter which can exist for a longer time at a particular temperature and pressure. So we see there are three basic states of matter: solid, liquid and gases. Other two extensions are plasma and PTC. Most of the gases will be discussing, that will be including solid, liquid and gases. Taking example of water. Three beakers, B1, B2, B3. We have taken three beakers. Let it be only one beaker. Same beaker. In first beaker, we have kept some ice part, ice cubes. So this is solid state, this is ice, that is solid. Once we give heat to this beaker, once we heat it, what happens? All of you know what happens when we heat ice, it becomes water. So simple as that. So once we heat the ice, it will become water. So ice became water on heating. Which is liquid. Now, to the same beaker, if you give more heat, what will happen? Water will start evaporating, or this water will start vaporizing, or it will be converted to gaseous state. That means water will be converted to gaseous state. So, as we see, giving heat, water is changing its state. So, this is heat, water, water vapor, gas. On giving temperature, the water changes its state. So it is true with all the substances. All the substances, they can come into liquid state, they can come into gaseous state and further. So this is just the beginning or the example, first example, that water can change its state on application of temperature. So, change of state of matter, two factors can be written for that: effect of temperature and effect of pressure. So we saw one example of change of temperature. We'll be discussing effect of pressure later on. We'll be now discussing effect of temperature in a broader sense. What happens when temperature increases? From the last lectures, we can understand that whenever temperature increases, the particles, they start moving away from each other. Their kinetic energy increases. They move from one another at a greater speed. They have more kinetic energy in them because they absorb the heat that is applied to them. That means temperature increases, kinetic energy increases, intermolecular space increases. So, intermolecular space increases means solid will become liquid, liquid will become gas. So, this is the effect of temperature. For example, this was a solid substance. On giving heat, became liquid. On giving heat again, it became gas. The interparticle space or intermolecular space will increase. So effect of temperature, that means increase the temperature, kinetic energy will be increased, intermolecular space will be increased, and substance will come from solid to liquid, and again on application of temperature again to gas. So these are the applications of effect of temperature on the change of state of matter. Next, whenever there is change of temperature, there are two possibilities: melting and boiling. Melting and boiling. Melting means whenever the solid changes to liquid, and boiling means liquid changes to gas. So there are two points: melting point and boiling point. So this can be defined as, wetting point can be defined as the point at which the temperature at which solid gets converted to liquid and boiling point is the temperature at which liquid gets converted. So these are the melting point and boiling point. One graph we can draw for this, that from solid to liquid, again from liquid to gas, the graph will look like number one, what is diffusion and how solid and gas get diffused in liquid. Number two, what are melting
point and boiling point. Number 3, what is Brownian motion? How it is related to degree of diffusion?
So 3 questions you have to solve, and most of you are trying to solve it. 2 questions I have got, that is very good. Keep solving it, keep answering, and send the answers in the ERP. We will be seeing, checking your copies when you come back to school again. Thank you, and have a nice time and happy learning. Thank you.